We're going to learn about what an inverse matrix is now. Inverse matrices are very important in matrix algebra. And it's important to know that not all matrices are invertible. If a matrix is invertible, we say it has an inverse matrix, but many matrices are not invertible. So we're going to touch on that topic in this video, and then we're going to go into more depth later on. So what is an inverse matrix? So if a matrix is invertible, then we can write that A times its inverse, which we denote as A to the minus 1, is equal to the identity matrix. Okay? So it's like the multiplication inverse for numbers. And it doesn't matter the order that you write this. So this is the same as A inverse A. Okay? A has to be a square matrix. A has to be n by n, a square matrix. And as I said, not all matrices are invertible. So there are some certain relationships. If you have the product of two invertible square matrices, and you want to find the inverse of that, this works similar to the way that the transpose works. This is B inverse times A inverse. It's a relatively simple proof, and I'm going to leave it to you guys for an exercise. The other one is, what if you're looking for the inverse of the transpose matrix? Okay, this is the inverse matrix transpose. So that's another fact or theorem that I'll leave it to you to do in the exercises. Okay, so what I want to do in this video is really compute the inverse of a 2x2 matrix. So we can set up some equations, right? So let's look at the 2x2 matrix. So we're going to have a general 2x2 matrix, A, B, C, D. And I want to multiply this matrix by its inverse to get the identity matrix. So the inverse is the matrix that we don't know. So that's going to be an unknown matrix. So let me write that as the first column, I'll write as x1, y1. And the second column, I'll write as x2, y2. And that's supposed to be the identity matrix. So let me write that out. That's supposed to equal 1, 0, 0, 1. OK? So the goal here is to determine what is the inverse of this 2x2 matrix, right? So I should make this clear. This one is our matrix A. This one is our matrix A inverse. And this one is the identity matrix, okay? So we want to find A inverse. Okay, how do we do that? Well, we have to write down equations. Okay, if we write down the equations that this matrix product represents, then maybe we can solve for the unknowns. So let's see, what is this? So we use matrix multiplication. So we have AX1 plus BY1. AX1 plus BY1 is equal to 1, right? And then we have AX2 plus BY2. And what is that equal to? That's equal to 0, right? Then in the second row, we have CX1 plus DY1. And that one is equal to 0. And finally, we have CX2 plus DY2. And that's this last element here, which is 1. OK, we have four unknowns, x1, y1, and x2, y2. And we have four equations. So you'd think we can solve for all the unknowns. OK, so how would we do that? I think the easiest way is to use these equations with the 0 on the right-hand side. Those are called homogeneous equations. And we can solve those equations for the y's. So we can solve for y1. We can solve for y2. So let's do that. I can put that over here. Solve for y1 first. So dy1 equals minus cx1. So then we solve for y1. So we get y1, right, minus cx1 divided by d. So minus c over dx1, right? And the second equation we can solve for y2. So we can subtract minus ax2 and divide by b. So minus a over b. So this is y2 equals minus a over b times x2. Okay? So we can eliminate y1 and y2 in favor of x1 and x2. So now we go to the first equation. So let's see, we eliminate y1, so we get ax1 plus by1, so by1, so instead of plus, we can use minus here, minus bc over d, x1 equals 1, right? We can multiply by d and divide by d, right? And then solve this equation for x1. So you can factor out an x1, and then you have times ad minus bc divided by d, and then you can bring that to the other side. So if you let me skip some algebra steps, and hopefully don't make a mistake, we can have x1 equal to, so we have AD minus BC over D, and we flip that, so that's D over AD minus BC. Okay, so we've got X1. If we've got X1, then we also have Y1, right? So Y1 is in terms of X1, so it's minus C over D X1, the D cancels, so it becomes minus C over AD minus BC. Okay, we're good. Now we need to find X2 and Y2. So we have a Y2 here in terms of X2. So now we need to use the fourth equation, right? We just used the first equation. So now we need the fourth equation. So we substitute in y2. Let me write it down here. So we have cx2 plus dy2. So that becomes minus ad over bx2 equal to 1. Again, we do the same thing. So we have a b here in the denominator. So we have bc. And then b. And then we can solve this for x2. So we get x2. Let me do it down here first. So we get x2 equals b over bc minus ad. So bc minus ad is just the negative of ad minus bc. So we can change the sign here. So we can write x2 equals minus b over ad minus bc. OK, we're almost done. We have x2, so now we just need y2. So y2 is equal to minus a over b x2, so the minus signs cancel, that becomes then a over ad minus bc. Okay, so we've got the result. So let me put it here. I'll use a different color so you see that. So sorry, I'm going to write on my face, and maybe a little bit lower. So we have a inverse then, okay? So what is A inverse? So x1, x2, So there's always a 1 over AD minus BC. So 1 over AD minus BC. And then we have the matrix. The matrix is X1, X2, so D minus B. And then we have Y1, Y2, so we have minus CA. Okay, that's the inverse matrix. So interesting, A, B, C, D, the inverse of that is 1 over AD minus BC. And then the matrix itself, the diagonal elements switch. So we have DA, and then we just negate the off-diagonal elements, minus B and minus C. This piece here, AD minus BC, is what we call the determinant of A, is AD minus BC. And that's for a 2x2 matrix. So that is this 2x2 matrix, the determinant is AD minus BC. And the interesting thing here is that if AD minus BC equals 0, you're dividing by 0. So there is no inverse matrix. So if the determinant of A equals 0, then the inverse does not exist. Okay, the matrix is not invertible. That's a very important result, and we'll go into that more for the general n by n matrix. Okay, this formula for the inverse of a 2x2 matrix is something I typically don't remember, but you know, if you're a student in a matrix algebra course, it's probably a good idea to memorize this formula, okay? So what have we done? We've introduced the idea of the inverse matrix. A inverse is equal to A inverse A is the identity matrix. We have some identities. A B inverse is B inverse A inverse. A transpose inverse equals A inverse transpose. And then we've derived, using solving a system of 4 equations and 4 unknowns, we derived a formula for the inverse of a 2x2 matrix. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.